short message. That's a short message on the Parsha. We are starting a new Sefer, Sefer Dvarim, which that in itself needs its own introduction, understanding the Sefer, understanding what it's all about, when this Sefer took place, and what is the message of this Sefer. So if you look right in the beginning of Sefer Dvarim, of Parsha's Dvarim, Eila Dvarim Asher Dibur Moshe El Kol Yisrael Be'ver Yardin, Ba'midbar Ba'rava Mulsuf, Bein Paran Ubein Tofel, Lavan V'chatzeres V'dizav. It's describing where Moshe Rabbeinu spoke to Am Yisrael. When did he say it? So it says, Achadas Aryom Echorv Derech Arseir, Vayhi Ba'arbaim Shana, the third pasuk, on the 40th year of the Jewish people when they left Mitzrayim, Be'ashtei Asar Chodesh, on month number 11. What month is that? The month of Rosh Chodesh Shvat, Be'echad LaChodesh. So Rosh Chodesh Shvat, the last month, the last full month of Moshe Rabbeinu's life. When was Moshe Rabbeinu Nifter? He was Nifter on Zayin Adar. He started saying this Sefer on Rosh Chodesh Shvat. Be'ashtei Asar Chodesh, Be'echad LaChodesh, Diber Moshe El Bnei Yisrael, Kechol Asher Tziva Hashem Oso Aleim, everything that he commanded them to do. So this is sort of the last message of Moshe Rabbeinu to Bnei Yisrael. But the question is, and this is really a question that the Mefarshim discuss, is who actually wrote Sefer Dvarim? Who wrote this book, right? So this book is called Mishneh Torah. It's the repetition of the Torah. Who wrote it? Did Hashem write it and Moshe spoke it? Or did Moshe Rabbeinu speak it by himself? And there's different questions, lekan ulekan, who exactly wrote it and what's the significance of this Sefer? Because the Barbanel is the one who addresses this question, and the Barbanel asks questions. May, if you want to tell me that Hashem wrote it, I'll ask you a few questions, because it really seems like Moshe Rabbeinu is the one who wrote it. First of all, right in the beginning, it says, Ho Moshe Be'er Es HaTorah Azos. Moshe Rabbeinu is repeating a lot of the story and a lot of the facts that we already know that already happened earlier part of the four books of Moses, the first four. And if you want to tell me that Hashem wrote it, so then why is the entire language different in this Sefer than in the previous four Sfarim? In the other four Sfarim, it says, Vaydaber Hashem l'Moshe Lemor, Tzavis b'nei Yisrael v'amarta aleim. That's the nusach, the linguist, the language, the form in which the first four books are in. But in this Sefer, it's like, oh, v'nefin, v'nesa, Vayomer Hashem Elai, and Hashem spoke to me. It's like Moshe Rabbeinu repeating the story. It sounds as if Moshe Rabbeinu is the one who is speaking. In fact, the Gemara in Megillah, Adaf Lamed Aleph, says that the klalos in Torah's Kohanim, they're Mipia Gvura, but the klalos at the end of Sefer Dvarim, they're given by Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Mipia Atzmo Amar. So you see that it's Moshe Rabbeinu and not a Kodesh Baruch. But on the other hand, says the Barbanel, and he quotes, no, if you want to tell me that it's Moshe Rabbeinu who spoke it, why is it called Torah? Why is it part of the five books of Moses? Maybe it should be a part of it's the four books of given from Hashem, and the fifth one is from Moshe Rabbeinu. He says also, if you want to tell me that it's Moshe Rabbeinu, the one who spoke, there are new mitzvos that appear in Sefer Dvarim that don't appear in any other Sefer. So it's mashma that it's given by a Kodesh Baruch Hu. Or the Gemara in Sanhedrin says, if you say that the Torah is given min Hashemai, but this one pasuk, Moshe Rabbeinu made it up himself, you're kofer in the Torah. So the Gemara in Sanhedrin, Daf Tzadi Tes, look it up. It says that if you believe that one pasuk in the Chamisha Chumshei Torah, Moshe Rabbeinu made up by himself, you're kofer in the Torah. It's mashma that it's given by a Kodesh Baruch Hu. So the Barbanel throws us into this question, trying to understand who exactly wrote Sefer Dvarim. And the truth is that the Mefarshim go lekan ulekan, the way the Ramban and the Orach Chaim HaKadosh, and you can look those up, fascinating the way they describe it. Really, they're saying that it's Moshe Rabbeinu who wrote it, but even though Moshe Rabbeinu is the one who wrote it and he spoke it out himself, Hashem agreed with everything he said, and Hashem gave it the shtempel, and Hashem told him, now I want you to write this. This is going to be, your speech is going to be a part of the Torah. And that's why the Gemara says that even the last few psukim, the last 11 psukim, where it says that Moshe Rabbeinu died and Yeshua took them in, Moshe Rabbeinu wrote them with tears in his eyes, and then he was nifter. Meaning Hashem told him what to write. Hashem told Moshe Rabbeinu, this is going to make it into the Chamisha Chumshei Torah. That's how the Ramban and the Orach Chaim HaKadosh explain that it's really Moshe Rabbeinu spoke it from himself, and Hashem told him afterwards, and he dictated it, and he said, it needs to be written down and be a part of the five books of Moses that are given by Hashem. Hashem was maskim with every single thing that he said, and therefore it made it into the Torah, and even Hashem added new commandments that are part of the Torah. The Gon and the Maharal, they have some sort of some middle ground that really it's Hashem said it, and Moshe Rabbeinu repeated it, but from his own language, meaning the first four Svarim, Hashem spoke through Moshe Rabbeinu. It was mamish like Hashem speaking through Moshe Rabbeinu. It was direct Nevuah. But this Nevuah, Moshe Rabbeinu heard it, he understood it, and now he's saying it from himself like any other Navi, and therefore it reaches like a lower level of Kedusha, so to speak, than anything else. But the most fundamental thing that I want to discuss here is really what Moshe Rabbeinu did while transmitting the Torah of the Mishnah Torah. See, the Mishnah Torah is something that is very fascinating, right? You could try to imagine what it's like. You're the great leader of the Jewish people. You are the savior. You took them out of Egypt. You are the miracle worker. You make tremendous miracles. You're the one who is guiding the people and telling them the word of God throughout your entire career, 40 years in the desert. This is what Moshe Rabbeinu's, you know, he's our leader. He's the one who took us out of Mitzrayim. This was his entire life, leading the Jewish people out of Egypt. Now he's a month before he's about to die. If we could just imagine for ourselves, somebody who lives his whole life, and now he has a dream to go into the land of Eretz Yisrael, and he's not able to go into Eretz Yisrael. He has a passion to be with the people, and he knows that his life is coming to an end. Now, what will you do in that last month? What will be your messages? Will you just like speak about the past and reminisce? Will you just, you know, give them some mussar? Will you just complain? Will you spend your last days in isolation, just connecting to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and trying to perfect yourself and make sure that you're going up to Hashem the best possible way? Moshe did none of that. Moshe spent the last month of his life every single day getting up there and saying over the entire Sefer Dvarim. Now, it's brought down B'Shem Reb Chaim Volozhin, who heard this B'Shem the Gra, that the entire Sefer Dvarim is divided into 10 parshios, Nitzav and Vayelech go together, and it represents the last 1,000 years of the sixth thousand years. We know that the world is 6,000 years, and the seventh is Yemos HaMashiach. So what are the Jewish people going to experience in the last 1,000 years, right? We're in year 7,780, Tav Shin Pei. So we're already 780 years into this 1,000 years. So we're in Parsha. I don't know what Parsha that is. That's the eighth Parsha that we're in. That's what the Gra is known to be saying, meaning there's something very special about the message that Moshe Rabbeinu is saying. Moshe Rabbeinu is not just repeating history over here. He's actually decided to dedicate the last month of his life to give the Jewish people the package, the tools, to understand what type of society are we planning on building and how we're going to build it. Moshe Rabbeinu actually, during this time period, the last month of his life, is probably when he got the name Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe our Rebbe. This, for the first time, Moshe decides to be a Rebbe and to teach Am Yisrael the lessons that they need to learn. And not only that, he's teaching Am Yisrael to become teachers themselves. Moshe Rabbeinu understands that you could be a great leader, you could take your people out of slavery, and you can make them free, but that is not everlasting, because maybe another nation will come, unfortunately what happened, and will take them back into slavery. It happened by Churban HaBayis the first, and happened by Churban HaBayis the second, meaning world history is not in our control. So you could liberate a people, You could be a warrior. You could be victorious. You could lead Am Yisrael to freedom. But if you're not able to educate them with the values that will be able to sustain them so that they could create their perfect society in Eretz Yisrael, and that even when they're kicked out of Eretz Yisrael, they have the tools of how to create that society in whatever exile they're in, and with the yearning to come back, to create it back in Eretz Yisrael, so then all of that victory is for nothing. All of that freedom is for nothing. And therefore, Moshe Rabbeinu turns from becoming Moshe HaNavi, from Moshe HaManhig, he becomes Moshe Rabbeinu. And that's how he is forever remembered in the consciousness of the Jewish people, right? Eliyahu is known as Eliyahu HaNavi, right? We have many great manhigim who lead the people, but Moshe Rabbeinu's name becomes Moshe Rabbeinu. He's our Rebbe. He's here to teach us. That's why it says this word doesn't actually appear in the first four books of the Torah. Hoil Moshe Be'er Es HaTorah Azos. He's now going back and he's being Meva'er. He's like, let me explain to you what this tradition is all about. Let me explain to you what all of these commandments that Hashem gave you, what they're all about. Let me explain to you how they could create that perfect society. Hoel Moshe Be'er Es HaTorah Azos. Only at the end of Sefer Dvarim, you have it again, where it comes to Be'er Eitev. Moshe Rabbeinu tells him, write down the Torah on 11 different stones and bring Be'er Eitev. Make sure that it's clear, that it's understood. That's what Moshe Rabbeinu decided to dedicate the last month of his life, is to explain to us why we're Jewish, to explain to us why we have Torah, why we have mitzvot, so that we feel it, so that we are able to experience it and pass it on to our children. And that's why in Sefer Dvarim, in this book, it is the first time also that we find the verb of lelamed, to teach. This is the first time that we have this concept of lelamed, of teaching the Torah to Am Yisrael, right? It appears in Parshas Vayeschanan, where Hashem says, where Moshe Rabbeinu says, Vehodatem levanecha velivnei vanecha, make sure to teach it over to your children. It continues to the two parshios of Kriya Shema that we have in Sefer Dvarim, in Parshas Vayeschanan. And it says, "Velimadetem osam es b'neichem," right? And you should teach your children. You should teach your children. Also, the next, and it says, "Make sure to teach your." Ki yishalcha bincha. The whole story about Gadol shel Pesach. Ki yishalcha bincha machar leimor in Perek Vav. Ve'amarta lebincha. Make sure to give this over to your children. So not only is Moshe Rabbeinu teaching Am Yisrael, he's telling each and every one of us, you must all become teachers. Every single one of Am Yisrael needs to become a teacher, at the very least to teach himself and to teach his family. And that's also in Parshas Ekev and Perek Yud Aleph. He's telling us, the second parsha of Kriya Shema, right? Throughout this whole Sefer, Moshe Rabbeinu is becoming the teacher of Am Yisrael. And not only that, he's telling us, now you become the teacher. You teach your children and teach your grandchildren. Moshe Rabbeinu, with this understanding, in a way, set the course for the future of Judaism in this entire Sefer. And he's the one who turned us into the people of the book. Moshe Rabbeinu, in the last month of his life, educated us in understanding of the Torah and empowered us to all to be teachers. Some of us will become professional teachers and educators. Others will become teachers of their families and of their immediate community and friends and the rabbi of the family. Some of us will just become teachers to our own son and maybe to our grandson. But every single one of us has to become a teacher, has to be a part of the Mesorah, part of educating the Jewish tradition. Why are we Jewish? Why do we keep the Torah? Why do we love Eretz Yisrael? Why does Hashem want us to be you know, the chosen people. Why does he want us to keep Shabbos? Let's educate our children with that. That's what Moshe Rabbeinu was doing the last month of his life. Oh, el Moshe Beres HaTorah Zos. And if you don't know, that's what Moshe Rabbeinu ends. Shal Avicha Ve'Yagedcha Zekenecha Ve'Yomru Lach. If you don't know, so ask your parents, ask your grandparents, ask your Rabbeim, ask the Zekenim. We're going to create a culture of education. Can you imagine? We're probably the only society that has such a culture that is embedded in that. Look at the Zoom. Look at the thousands of Zooms around the Jewish world. We're getting together every single day to learn, to experience just the concept of learning values and meaning and purpose. What other people does that? It's not a specific job. It's not a webinar on marketing and a webinar on how to increase more clients to your social media. That's not what it's about, right? It's about understanding values and meaning. And that is something that is fascinating. That is something that is unbelievable. And that's something that Moshe Rabbeinu did in this Sefer in the last month of his life. And I think that's something very powerful for us to take into our life. It's the understanding that I'm a teacher. The understanding that even if I'm a young student, I am learning in order to teach somebody in the future. Right now, I might be a teenager. Right now, I might not even have any children, but I am learning because one day I will be empowered to be a teacher and an educator. And we have a culture of daf yomi, where it's groups of people who are not necessarily educators, but they're teaching a daf gemara every day, and people are coming together, chaburas of people who are learning. And they're sure, what an unbelievable nation that we have, which are called the people of the book, because we are obsessed with learning, and we're the ones who introduced public education, and that every single member of society should be literate and should have the right to get the basic education, and that they should know the tradition of their heritage. We're the ones who introduced that to the world, and it's something that we should be proud of, but it's something that's very, it's very empowering, but also very big mechayev. It's demanding of us to understand that we're here to learn, but not just to learn for ourselves, but to learn in order to teach. And I think looking around here on this Zoom, we see how special Am Yisrael is and how special we are, and that we have the opportunity to actually teach Am Yisrael how to enter Eretz Yisrael, because that's what this Sefer is all about, to prepare us to make our way into Eretz Yisrael. Thank you very much, everybody.